Hi, in this video we will explore the functionality of the spatial tab in the Sheetlink. It is a new feature of the Sheetlink 1.4 version. So in this model we don't have any rooms or spaces, so this dropdown is important because it switches the context between the spaces and rooms. If you want to use the spaces switch, everything will be configured to use the spaces. Or if you want to use rooms, you configure to use rooms, okay? Let's take a look in a model that already has some rooms. Sample model. We can go to Diroots, Sheetlink, Spatial tab, and we can check. Of course, you can search here, you can select, you can even select highlighted element, right-click on it, then show highlighted element in the model, and so on. If you need to find the information about the room in properties window. So what we can do? Basic workflow is like this. You select the rooms that you want to export. In this case, we selected all rooms. Okay, let's sort by number as an example. We can sort by instance and read only parameters. Rooms don't have type parameters, so that's why you don't see here type. And what we can export along the predefined parameters is, as an example, let's see on which level rooms are sitting. Okay, and maybe, well, let's see, export to comments. Maybe we have some comments. Okay, so we can clear this search, and what we will be able to do, we can export the template, export to Excel, and let's call it rooms for now, just for sake of this exercise. Okay, and what you will see here that we have a list with a room number, room name, okay, and we can add a different parameters here and we can populate the values and so on. But let's take as an example how we can create a new rooms out of nothing, let's say like that. To do that, you have a bit detailed instruction here on the workflow what you need to do. But let me demonstrate you. These three cells are important. So what we can do, we can copy them and we can do something like this. Let's paste them. You need to provide the number, name, and the phase in which room exists. Let me do just brief so we can easily differentiate new rooms from the existing ones. These are existing that have element ID. One point is very important. Don't copy the element ID, otherwise Sheetlink will lose the mapping of the existing and the new rooms. New rooms should have blank element ID field. Okay. So what we can do, let's be naive. Let's put something very naive, very straightforward. New number 001. Okay. Let's put new room name 001. Of course, dropdown is used to pick easily the phase of the room. That is very important. Otherwise, without that, rooms will go to the default phase and you will find it difficult to find where are the rooms that you wanted to have. Let's propagate these. And what we can do now, we can click save. Now we can go to import, preview import, and let's go to rooms. Okay, so here is our template and we will see that we have new rooms here. Let's update the model. Model updated successfully. How we can inspect, do we have a rooms or not? Maybe let's go to schedules because I know that we have one room schedule and we can click open view. So this is our list of the, we can go to the list of room schedule. Okay. And let's reset the filters here so we don't create a new room schedule. In case we have any filter, we will say no, sorting and grouping by number, which is fine. And we can see now the list of the rooms that we have in the model and on the bottom. You will see that we have new rooms with a new number, new name, and phase, correct phase set. So we can use these rooms in place in our models. Okay, let's take a bit different approach. Maybe if we close down this and move to this model. This model, if you go to room schedule, does not contain any single room. Let's add the room name. As an example, name is something that is important for us at this stage. Okay, so we don't have any rooms. What we can do? One simple workflow in the sheet link. We open, go to spatial. We notice that we don't have any rooms or any spaces. Okay, it's empty. But yet again, this button is available to us. It means it says export template. If you click export template and we export to Excel, let's call it new rooms. Okay, we will have a blank template called new rooms. Okay, let's close this one. And on the other hand, I have one Excel file that contains a list of the rooms, like this one. So what we can do, we can select these rooms, okay, like this, copy, we can paste them there. So we have a numbers names, but don't forget, you need to associate some fields. What we will do now, just double click here. So all rooms, new rooms that will be created will be assigned to correct space. And this is all. You don't have any element ID because these are rooms that doesn't exist in the Revit model itself. What we can do, we can click save. File is called new rooms. Okay, let's close this one. Let's minimize this one. And what we can do, we click import, import from Excel. New rooms is the template. We click open, model updated successfully, fraction of the second. Let's now go to the room schedule. And voila, we have a bunch of rooms that are created from the blank Excel template. And what we can do, we can always go to, for example, floor one. We can pick from the list. Let's say this is electrical room, or this is like, I don't know, lounge area, and so on. Of course, we can apply color scheme by name, and you will see that we successfully applied create rooms in the Excel file, updated model, and now we can manually place the rooms in a correct locations. What else we can do in the spatial tab? What I explained here is three necessary parameters that are required, but you can, along these three parameters that you need to fill in, like a number, name, and phase, you can add any number of other custom parameters. So while creating new rooms, you can even populate in the same time their values, parameter values. Let me explain what I mean by that. Let's create like a 2 to 3 rooms and let's populate some values. Okay. So what we will do, let's select at least one room. Okay. Let's sort by instance and let's see which parameter we can, let's say comments. As an example, we want to export comments also. So I will export to Excel and let's call it new rooms with parameters. Okay, wait a second. And we see. So in a nutshell, what we can do, just start typing the number. Like, for example, NN101. And we can create like two more rooms. Let's call it new name 001. Okay. Then we can use the phase. And in the comments, we can place value like NN101 demo comment. We can expand a bit. Let's put 001 so we can find is Sheetlink applying the correct values. Okay, save. And now what will happen? This is the existing room. These are the new rooms. Okay, that will be created. But along creation, we will apply the parameter values to the comments. Okay, let's import back. Import from Excel. New New rooms with parameters is the name of the Excel file, updated successfully. And what we can do now, we can go to schedules as an example, room schedule, open view. We can see our schedule. Okay. And let's unlock the comments column to see. And you see, we created new rooms. These are their number, name, and respective comment parameter value. So, hope this tool will speed up your workflow in terms of creating rooms and spaces. We didn't explain anything about spaces because the workflow is exactly same for the rooms. You just roll back to spaces. You can export a template with existing spaces or completely blank template, so you can add new elements in your model. Of course, the placement of rooms needs to be done manually. Sheetlink will just inject these in your Revit model. Thank you, and see you in the next video. Bye.